if you want to indulge in the best of undisturbed wilderness, you should visit the western coast. The constantly changing flora, scenery, and climate will never stop amazing you.
All I have,
this is Tasmania.
Wherever I go.
Hi guys, and welcome to another brand new episode of Travel Bugs. You have caught us in the middle of our week-long road trip in the beautiful island state of Tasmania.
In the last video, we have covered places in Hobart and Bruny Island. We will leave the link in the description if you haven't watched it. The goal for today's video is to drive along the west coast of Tasmania. You can use our video as a guide if you are planning to visit this beautiful state. And without any further delay, let's start the video.
But before that, let me just remind you to please hit the thumbs up button if you enjoy watching this video. You can also subscribe to our channel and hit the bell notification icon if you haven't done so already. This way you will get a notification whenever we upload a video. Also, watch this video till the end and let us know your feedback in the comment section below. So let's begin.
After we took off from Mount Wellington, which was our last stop in Hobart, we drove 93 kilometers to reach the Mount Field National Park. The stunning natural flora offers a constantly changing view. The Mount Field Park is part of the Tasmanian Wilderness World Heritage Area. And the star attraction here is the breathtaking three-tiered Russell Waterfalls, arguably one of the most impressive falls in the state. Begin your leisure walk from the visitor center through towering tree ferns, giant eucalyptus, and enchanting water creeks. You will also find longer day walks here.
Guys, one more thing. If you're coming to Russell Falls and you're planning to come here during the night, there is something called the Glowworm Grotto. So just as you near the falls, you'll have this particular area which will be completely filled with glowworms during the night. So if you have any flashlights, you can just switch it off. But you have a hand railing that you can hold and go walk towards the falls.
Over 40% of Tasmania is covered under national park. In order to get into this park, you need to have a valid Tasmania National Park pass. What we got was an 8-week holiday pass for $80. You can buy this either online or at the visitor center within the park. So we will leave more details regarding this in the description. So if you are interested, please check it out.
After soaking in the place, we went to our motor home to cook some lunch.
This is why we need a motor home. ഇവിടെ സമയം 3 മണിയായി. നല്ല വിശപ്പ്. എവിടെ വേണമെങ്കിലും നിർത്താം, എവിടെ വേണമെങ്കിലും കുക്ക് ചെയ്യാം, എവിടെ വേണമെങ്കിലും കിടന്നുറങ്ങാം.
Okay, so what are you cooking for today's lunch?
Today is I have some avocados and I've got some egg omelette and a spinach wrap.
Okay.
So I'm gonna mix it all together and I'm giving you a wrap along with some spicy and sweet chili sauce.
From Mount Field Park, we drove another 260 kilometers to reach Strawn Beach Caravan Park. You will be driving over the Instagram famous 99 bends to reach Strawn. And if you have a drone, you can get some pretty good aerial shots on a sunny day. We reached the caravan park at 9 PM and called it a night. Next morning, we took off from Strawn Caravan Park through Queenstown to the Iron Glow Lookout Point. It was raining slightly and most of the road was covered with fog. The Iron Glow Lookout overlooks a copper mining site of the 1800s, giving you a bird's eye view of the open-cut mine with stains of mineral deposits on the wall. It is a very beautiful sight, but it is best to come here on a sunny day if you want to capture the brilliance of the color. A cantilever platform provides a better view of the site. Entry here is free, and we were the only ones the morning we visited.
Good morning, guys. We are still in the west coast of Tasmania, and right behind me is the Horsetail Waterfall. It's just on the way, and it's a very beautiful sight from a distance here.
From the Iron Glow Lookout Point, we then drove to the Corina River via a small town called Zihan to reach the edge of the world.
Zihan will be the last stop before the edge of the world. You know, so make sure you fill your tank at Zihan. It's
You need to take this barge to cross the Korina River. But be mindful that the service is sometimes suspended if the weather is not good. So if you're taking this route, please check ahead. We drove for 109 km on mostly white gravel straight road before reaching the edge of the world.
After driving for 3 hours, we finally made it to the edge of the world.
This is in the Arthur River and it's considered one of the largest expanses between this part of Tasmania and Argentina. There's no other land pass between both these continents starting from here.
This place is neatly maintained with a short wooden broadwalk and a lookout point. The edge of the world is the starting of the longest uninterrupted stretch of ocean in the world. We sat here for some time before heading out.
We finally reached our caravan park for tonight. So this is located in Stanley, and this caravan park is right under the Nut, which was once an active volcano. The other speciality of the site is the beach is right behind our parking spot. So let's go check it out.
The view was simply calming. We spent our evening walking along the windy beach, and while heading back to our site, we also spotted few fairy penguins.
So നമ്മൾ ഇവിടെ ക്രഡൽ മൗണ്ടൻ വിസ്റ്റ സെന്ററിലാണ്. സോ നമ്മൾ ഓൾറെഡി നാഷണൽ പാർക്കിൻ്റെ എൻട്രി വാങ്ങിച്ചതുകൊണ്ട് ഇവിടെ നമുക്ക് എക്സ്ട്രാ ടിക്കറ്റ് എടുക്കേണ്ട ആവശ്യം വരുന്നില്ല, ഇല്ലെങ്കിൽ ഇവിടെ $40 എക്സ്ട്രാ എടുക്കണം. പിന്നെ ഇവിടെ ഷട്ടിൽ സർവീസസ് ഉണ്ട്. സോ ക്രഡൽ മൗണ്ടനിൽ തന്നെ ഒരുപാട് ലുക്കൗട്ട്സ് ഉണ്ട്. സോ ദിസ് ബസ് വിൽ ടേക്ക് യു അറൌണ്ട് ദോസ് ലുക്കൗട്ട്സ് ആൻഡ് കം ബാക്ക്. പിന്നെ നമ്മൾ ഇന്ന് പോകാൻ പോണ സ്ഥലം വന്നിട്ട് ഡൗ ലേക്ക് ആണ്. സോ ദർ ഇസ് ഷട്ടിൽ ബസ് ഓവർ ദേർ ആൻഡ് വിൽ ടേക്ക് ദ ബസ് ആൻഡ് വിൽ ഗോ ടു ദ ഡൗ ലേക്ക്. സോ അങ്ങനെ നമ്മൾ ബസ് ഷട്ടിലൊക്കെ എടുത്തിട്ട് ഡൗ ലേക്കിൻ്റെ സ്റ്റോപ്പിൽ ഇറങ്ങി. അപ്പോൾ ഡൗ ലേക്ക് കംപ്ലീറ്റ് ഒരു സർക്യൂട്ട് ചെയ്യാൻ 2 to 3 hours എടുക്കും. ഒരു 6 kilometer ലൂപ്പാണ്. ഇറ്റ്സ് നോട്ട് എ ഡിഫിക്കൽട്ട് വാക്കിംഗ് ട്രെയിൽ അല്ല, ഒരു മീഡിയം ഫേസ് വാക്കിംഗ് ട്രെയിൽ ആണ്. പുറകിൽ കാണുന്നതാണ് അതിൻ്റെ വ്യൂ.
Isn't it just amazing how people and places can make a huge difference in our thoughts? We enjoy traveling and it becomes the best when we can get to do it together. Keep people who make you happy the closest to your heart and learn to live, love and grow in this journey called life. Wishing you all a very happy new year from Travel Bugs. Stay tuned for our next vlog. Until then, it's us signing out.